Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Katlego. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to another video. I have not done that intro in like my last two videos. I kind of missed it. But anyway, welcome to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to become an environmental scientist in South Africa, as well as the pros and cons of becoming an environmental scientist. I would like to think of myself as well on my way to becoming an environmental scientist. I don't know. For some reason, I don't regard myself as an environmental scientist, but I kind of am. I'm not sure. I guess you guys will see as I read through the requirements to become an environmental scientist. You guys judge. You be the judge. You guys know my academic history and what I'm currently doing. So tell me down below, would you think? No, I'm phasing it wrong. Would you say I'm an environmental scientist? Yes or no? Tell me. First and foremost, what is an environmental scientist? An environmental scientist is a professional who uses scientific principles and methods to study and protect the natural environment. They may work on issues related to air and water quality, climate change, ecosystem management, waste management, or sustainable development. So they do a whole range of things. Like I said, environmental sciences is a very broad interdisciplinary field, so it includes and involves a lot of things, hence this definition. So to become an environmental scientist in South Africa, you need to. We're gonna go through this systematically. We're gonna go through this step by step, like one by one. So number one, you need to obtain a relevant degree. Obviously, to become a scientist, you need to go to school. I've talked about studying environmental sciences in university at WITS. I've also done another video for studying environmental sciences at UP. I'm gonna continue with the series with other institutions because I'm back, so don't think I just done those two and it's over. I'm gonna do the other universities. But number one, you need to obtain a relevant degree, either a bachelor's degree in environmental sciences, biology, chemistry, ecology, or related fields. This includes also like a BA in environmental management, a BSc in environmental management, any science related degree, I would say. And then you also need a master's degree or a PhD. I think need is a strong word. I'm gonna use the need. You need a master's degree or a PhD, because this may be a requirement depending on which company you are applying to. So for some companies, entry level jobs, like a minimum of a master's degree is done, which is another reason why I opted to just push through and get it done. So from a lot of people that I ask, they're like, a minimum is an honors, but I would say if you can get a master's, just go through and get a master's. Number two, you need to gain relevant work experience. Most environmental science positions require years of experience. So you need to either work in a consulting firm, government agencies, non-profit organizations, non-governmental organizations. I have a video, I will link it down below, where I talk about where you can work with an environmental scientist. Especially, I think that video was mainly aimed at people who have just completed their qualifications and they don't know what to do with it. There's a video, I'll put it in the description, where you can work and hopefully gain some work experience on your way to becoming an environmental scientist. I'm sorry. Number three, you need to register with a professional body. So in South Africa, the South African Council for Natural Scientific Professionals, the SACNS. Ooh, I always get it wrong. The SA CNASP is the professional body that regulates natural science professions, including environmental sciences. So to work as an environmental scientist in South Africa, you would need to register with this organization and meet the requirements for professional registration. I've seen it. I wasn't really sure whether I would need to register with this organization right now in my position. And I was thinking about it actually and talking to a friend of mine. I was like, it'd be interesting for me to do, I like the word interesting, it'd be good for me to do some research about these specific professional bodies that you need to register with, especially as an environmental science graduate, to know, because we don't really learn this in school. So hopefully a video will come. I'll note it down to make a video about that. So what these organizations even mean? Do you need to register? Is it just a thing on the side? So that was number three. Number four, you need to, I keep using the word need, but just know that it's just a, like, my usual word. I don't mean you need, I just say you need to to obtain certifications. So a lot of environmental scientists have certifications in a lot of different things within the environmental sciences sector. Like somebody might have an EIA certification or any other certification. So some environmental science position may require a certification in specialized areas. So they are specialized areas, such as hazardous waste management or air quality monitoring. And there are several organizations in South Africa that offer certification programs for environmental professionals. I personally do not know any. I only know about EIAs, guys, like, further research is needed. Anyway, number five, you need to keep up with continuing education. As a scientist, you are a lifelong learner. So one thing that we always do in our team at work is that every Monday when we have our team meeting, we have a paper presentation. So one person from our team would look for a paper, hopefully recent, specifically in our field, what we work with, what we do, and present that research to us. This is to keep up with what is currently happening in your industry. I think it applies to many other industries, because if you're working in economy, if you're an economist and you're working in the economic sector, you would need to like keep up with what is happening, what are the trends, all of these. So as an environmental scientist, you also need to keep up with the education and the research that is currently coming out in your field. As with many scientific fields, environmental science is constantly evolving, and staying up to date with the latest research and technologies is very important for professional growth and advancement. Many environmental science professionals engage in continuing education activities such as attending conferences, taking courses, and stay current in their field. So like last year, we went to the Conservation Symposium. That also serves as a way to stay up to date with current research in your field, because you get to engage with a lot of people, find out about their work, stay informed, you know. So those are the five things. Number one, let's go through them again. Number one, get a qualification, OBS. Number two, work experience. Number three, register with a professional body. Number four, obtain certification. And number five, keep up to date with the research, the education in your field. That is how you become an environmental scientist in South Africa. So I think this goes without saying that becoming an environmental scientist in South Africa requires a strong foundation in scientific principles. And it requires a lot of passion in protecting the natural environment, because one thing I've learned in my internship, you cannot do this without passion. Like, sometimes I'm like, how can people not understand? Like, what the, like, this is so simple. But then I realize it's simple to me. And in most cases, education is required to teach people about certain things. So hopefully my platform can serve as one of those places where people can learn more about stuff, and it can be a challenging career, frustrations and making decisions and like kuning and it can also be very rewarding when you see what difference your work is doing in the world, in our country. So for those interested in making a difference in the world, I know this gets thrown a lot around, but if you're very interested in making a difference, working in the environmental sector, that is how. And if you want to know more about specific courses in environmental sciences, you can watch the two videos I've made and all my other videos, because that is what I talk about. That is the main aim of this channel. The next thing I said I was going to talk about are the pros and cons of working as an environmental scientist. I don't know if I have enough time. I don't have enough time. So I guess I'll have to do a part two of this video. I will see you in the next video where I will talk about the pros and cons, as well as, let me check, whether as an environmental scientist you should work in industry or in academia/research. Which one is better? Working in research, academia, or working in industry? As well as, is it good? Is it bad? What are the benefits, pros, cons of working as an environmental scientist? I'll see you in part two. Bye-bye.